بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله
يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما All praise is due to Allah alone, the One, the Absolute, the Supreme, the Sublime, the Eternal, the Originator, the Creator, the Sustainer and Provider, the One who has encompassed everything in His knowledge, and nothing encompasses Him in their knowledge. The One who sees everything and nothing can see Him. لا تدركه الأبصار وهو يدرك الأبصار وهو اللطيف الخبير. لا تدركه الأبصار وهو يدرك الأبصار وهو اللطيف الخبير. Vision perceives Him not, but He perceives all vision. And He is the subtle, the acquainted. He is the One whose vision encompasses the entire creation and is not obstructed. إِنَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ بَصِيرٍ Indeed, He is, of all things, seeing. He sees all of His slaves, the righteous of them and the evil, and is witness over them. هُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ فَمِنْكُمْ مُؤْمِنٌ هُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ فَمِنْكُمْ كَافِرٌ وَمِنْكُمْ مُؤْمِنٌ وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ It is He who created you, and among you is the disbeliever, and among you is the believer, and Allah, of what you do, is all-seeing. He is the seer of His slaves. He sees His slaves. He is Al-Khabir, the perfectly acquainted with them and their affairs. He knows what is in their best interest. He knows who is most deserving of guidance and who is most deserving of misguidance. He is not asked about His actions, but they, mankind, are asked about their actions. And this is due to His wisdom, His absolute wisdom and His mercy. He is Al-Basir, the all-seeing, the most acquainted with the state of His slaves and servants. He knows whose affairs would be in order through wealth and riches. And He knows whose affairs would be in disarray and who would be corrupt through wealth and prosperity. Allah says, وَلَوْ بَسَطَ اللَّهُ الرِّزْقَ لِعِبَادِهِ لَبَغَوْا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَكِنْ يُنَزِّلُ بِقَدَرٍ مَّا يَشَاءُ إِنَّهُ بِعِبَادِهِ خَبِيرٌ بَصِيرٌ And if Allah had extended extensively provision for His servants, they would have committed tyranny throughout the earth. But He sends it down in a precise measure, which He wills. Indeed, He is of His servants, well acquainted and all-seeing, basir. He sees and knows all of the actions, every action and every sin, the major and the minor, the public and the private. وَكَفَى بِرَبِّكَ بِذُنُوبِ عِبَادِهِ خَبِيرًا بَصِيرًا And sufficient is your Lord concerning the sins of His slaves as acquainted and all-seeing. Al-Basir, the all-seeing, it is He who sees everything as a whole, not compartmentalized, but He sees everything as a whole while not missing the slightest detail. Al-Basir is He who sees the visible and the invisible, the manifest and the hidden. He sees without a sensory organ. He sees and He is free of dependence upon the pupil of the eye or an eyelid or a lens. He sees without effect on Him. He is the all-seeing who sees the black ant on the black stone on the moonless night. He sees the ant's organs and the nutrition flowing through its veins without need for magnification. He sees the distant objects, the galaxies and the stars and the planets and the moons. and he sees the large objects and the fine objects. He sees the atom and the subatomic particle and what is smaller than that still. He sees what no device can detect. He sees the deception of the eyes. يَعْلَمُ خَائِنَةَ الْأَعْيُنِ وَمَا تُخْفِي الصُّدُورِ. He sees the deception of the eyes and what the hearts, what the breasts conceal. He sees the turning of the hearts and the movement of the jinn and what is under the seven earths and what is above the seventh heaven. How can such a magnificent God, absolute in his knowledge, absolute in his sight, be equated to his creation? Or even worse, to a stone idol. Allah reprimanded the idolaters, those who worshipped statues, saying, أَلَهُمْ أَرْجُلٌ يَمْشُونَ بِهَا أَمْ لَهُمْ أَيْدٍ يَبْطِشُونَ بِهَا أَمْ لَهُمْ أَعْيُنٌ يُبْصِرُونَ بِهَا أَمْ لَهُمْ آذَانٌ يَسْمَعُونَ بِهَا. Do they have feet by which they walk? Or do they have hands by which they strike? Or do they have eyes with which they see? Or do they have ears with which they hear? His basar, his absolute and flawless vision and sight, is an attribute of his perfection. When compared to essentially everything is blind, so how can the creation be alike to the creator? قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الْأَعْمَى وَالْبَصِيرُ أَفَلَا تَتَفَكَّرُونَ. So is the blind equivalent to the seeing? Then will you not give thought? Allah confirmed his attribute of sight and vision. It is an attribute of his perfection, through which he sees the perfection of his creation's attributes, meaning that he sees every detail, minute, apparent and hidden. He knows the drivers and the intentions. He knows why we make our decisions. He sees our actions, our thoughts, our whims, our desires and our intentions. How then can our Lord, under his continuous gaze, be disobeyed? أَلَمْ يَعْلَمْ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ يَرَى. Does he not know that Allah sees? This divine quality of basar, ceaseless vision, drives us, my dear respected brothers and sisters, to be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, conscious of his ever-existing gaze over our apparent and over our inner state. How then can we disobey him in light of this knowledge? He has said, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ. And fear Allah and know that Allah is all-seeing of what you do. He sees everything. The believer does not take lightly the fact that Allah sees him and is aware of him. The one who hides something from one other than Allah, when he does not hide it from Allah, is a person who makes light of Allah's sight. Watching one step is a fruit of faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The one who draws near to sin, the one who draws near to sin while knowing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees him, oh, what a reckless man and loser he is. And the one who thinks that God, Allah, cannot see him when he sins, then what an unbeliever and ignoramus he is indeed. So how can we defy him? How can we disobey him in front of him, under his gaze, while he sees us? He sees us in our homes. He sees us in our rooms. He sees us alone in front of the TV and alone online. He sees us when we are at work. He sees us when we are in play. He sees us when we are on holiday. When the rules no longer count. The rules no longer count because nobody knows us when we're on holiday. And no one can see us, but he knows us and he sees us. The people lose their minds when they go on holiday. The hijab comes off, the bikini might go on, prayers are stopped, the gaze is set loose to look left and right and up and down. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees us. When we reside in our countries and when we are abroad on holiday. Umar radiallahu anhu, as we know in the famous story where he would go around the streets of Medina during the night to hear the people in their homes, to listen to what they say, so he can know their affairs and their state and their condition. Heard the mother who sold milk tell her daughter to mix water with the milk? And she said, and the daughter said, Umar has commanded us not to mix water with milk. And she said, well, Umar can't see us. And she said, but Allah can. Allah sees us, my dear respected brothers and sisters. A man went to Ibrahim ibn Adham, rahimahullah, and he said to him, Ya Aba Ishaq, O Abu Ishaq, admonish me, for indeed sins have overcome me. My desires have overcome me. So admonish me, give me a deterrent, tell me something that will deter me and save me from my sins. So Ibrahim ibn Adham, radiallahu anhu, he said to him, I will give you five things that if you are able to do, you have no worries and you can commit sins as you please. So he said, okay, tell me the first one. He said, if you wish to disobey Allah, then eat from provision that is granted to you from anyone but Allah. Eat from rizq that's not given to you from Allah. So he said, and how can I eat when the entire earth belongs to Allah? So Ibrahim ibn Adham said to him, so how is it befitting that you eat from his provision and disobey him? So the man said, give me the second. So he said, if you wish to disobey him, then do not live on his earth. He said, but where else can I go when to him belongs the dominion of the heavens and the earth? He said, then is it respectful that you live in his kingdom and you disobey him? So the man said, give me the third. He said, Ibrahim said, if you wish to disobey him, then find a place where you can disobey him where he cannot see you. So the man said, subhanallah. And is there anything that obscures his gaze? Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he said, then is that respectful that you disobey him while he sees you? The man said, give me the fourth. And he said, if you wish to disobey him, then when the angel of death comes to you, tell him, give me respite, give me some time so I can repent and do righteous deeds. And the man said, that is impossible. He will not accept my plea. He will not accept my plea with him. And he said, then if you have no power over your life and death, how can you disobey him? He said, okay, give me the fifth. He said, if you wish to disobey him, then when the angels of hellfire drag you to the hellfire, do not go with them. And he said, and do I possess such power over the angels? He said, then how is it that you wish to sin when you have no power over your salvation or your damnation? The man said, Ya Ibrahim, hasbi, hasbi. Oh Ibrahim, that is enough for me. That is enough for me. فَإِنِّي لَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْهِ. Indeed, I seek forgiveness from Allah and I repent to him. Therefore, my dear respected brothers and sisters, repentance, tawbah, is not from the sin only, but it is also for the audacity and temerity, for the impudence and insolence of disobeying Allah in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the one who has no piety that prevents him from disobeying Allah when he is in his private quarters or when he is secluded, then Allah gives no value to his public deeds. He who knows that he is observed, the one who knows that he is observed with scrutiny, perfects his actions. This is the station of Iman, my dear respected brothers. Everything we have mentioned so far is the level of Iman. Iman in Allah and his names and his attributes, his power, his might, His sight, his hearing, his knowledge, subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is Iman, to be conscious of Allah's gaze over us at all times. And as we know from the hadith of Jibreel, that there is a level higher than Iman, and that is Ihsan, perfection. As the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَن تَعْبُدَ اللَّهَ كَأَنَّكَ تَرَاهُ فَإِن لَمْ تَكُن تَرَاهُ فَإِنَّهُ يَرَاكَ. Ihsan is to worship Allah as though you can see him. For if you cannot see him, then surely he can see you. And Nawawi radiallahu anhu, he said, this is from Jawami'ul Kalim, the comprehensive, concise expression of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because if we were to estimate that somebody stood in worship while seeing the essence of his Lord the Almighty, he would leave nothing of submission and surrender and tranquility and excellent etiquette and presence, hudur, with his body and with his heart to complete his worship in the most perfect form. Except that he would do it if he knew that he could see Allah, if he could see Allah. And an example of a noble companion who worshipped Allah as though he could see Allah was Harith ibn Malik al-Nu'mani al-Ansari radiallahu anhu, whom the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw him one day and he said to him, Ya Haritha, kayfa asbaht? Oh Haritha, how are you this morning? And he said, I have awoken as a true believer. So the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, for everything there is a reality. So what is the reality of your statement, O Haritha? So he said, O Messenger of Allah, عَزَفَتْ نَفْسِي عَنِ الدُّنْيَا. My soul has turned its back on the world. فَأَقَمْتُ لَيْلِي. So I stayed up during the night in prayer. وَأَضْمَأْتُ نَهَارِي. And I made thirsty my days, meaning through fast. And it is as though I can see the throne of my Lord, and he has brought forward the judgment day. And it is as though I can see the inhabitants of paradise visiting each other within it. And it is as though I can see the dwellers of the hellfire. It is as though I can hear the wails and the howling of the dwellers of the hellfire. So the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, مُؤْمِنٌ نَوَّرَ اللَّهُ قَلْبَهُ. A believer, a sincere believer, whom Allah has illuminated his heart. This illumination of the heart is the result of Allah's love, my dear respected brothers and sisters. In the Hadith Qudusi, the divine Hadith where the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam narrates from his Lord the Almighty, where he says, whosoever shows enmity to a wali, to a friend, an ally of mine, I have declared war against him. And my servant does not draw near to me with anything more beloved to me than what I have made obligatory upon him. And my servant continues to draw near to me with nawafil. وَمَا زَالَ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلِ. My servant will continue to draw near to me through nawafil, through voluntary deeds. حَتَّى أُحِبَّهُ. Until I love him. For if I love him, I become the hearing with which he hears, and his sight with which he sees, and his hand with which he strikes, and his foot with which he walks. And if he were to ask me, I would grant him. And if he would seek refuge in me, I would grant him refuge. What does it mean that Allah would be the hearing with which he hears, and his sight with which he sees? First, my dear respected brothers, that the truth enters the heart without any obstruction. It permeates the heart and settles inside with tranquility. There is no rejection of the truth. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has opened the heart, then the truth enters the heart. And Allah will grant a furqan, a criterion, a standard, a measure by which he can discern between truth and falsehood. He has said, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, إِن تَتَّقُوا اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ فُرْقَانًا. O you who have believed, if you fear Allah, he will grant you a criterion, a furqan, where you can see between truth and falsehood. The believer who sees through Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is granted basira. Basira is not a sensory organ. It is not vision through the eye. Rather, it is the ability to understand instinctively through intuition, through, if you like, a sixth sense that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala endows his believer with. He sees with the light of Allah, the light of Allah that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam referred to, where he said, اتَّقُوا فَرَاسَةَ الْمُؤْمِنِ فَإِنَّهُ يَرَى بِنُورِ اللَّهِ. Fear the intuition of the believer, for indeed he sees with the light of Allah. His basirah grants his heart power in perceiving the truth. He can see the truth. He sees through the mist what was obscured and unveiled. What was obscured and it becomes unveiled. He sees What was formerly hazy then becomes clear. What was distant becomes near. Seeing with the eye of the heart penetrates the exteriors with insight and intuition to observe with clarity the reality of affairs. This piercing vision is that of the believers, my dear respected brothers and sisters. He has said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَآمِنُوا بِرَسُولِهِ يُؤْتِكُمْ كِفْلَيْنِ مِنْ رَحْمَتِهِ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ نُورًا تَمْشُونَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. O you who have believed, fear Allah and believe in His Messenger. He will then give you double portion of His mercy and make for you a light by which you will walk and forgive you. And Allah is all forgiving, all merciful. My dear respected brothers and sisters, the one who walks with the light of Allah, the one who walks on a path that is illuminated by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is one who does not go astray. He is one who is conscious of Allah first and of Allah's gaze over him, and then he ascends and rises to a level whereby he worships Allah as though he can see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us basira, to grant us clarity of vision, to enable us to distinguish between what is right and wrong, to discern between truth and falsehood so that we may not go astray. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us always conscious of Him, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enable us to worship Him as though we can see Him. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. إن الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على الحبيب المصطفى وبعد. My dear respected brothers and sisters, why is it when mankind wishes to live healthy, prosperous, happy lives, do they choose, do people choose the path of destruction, the path of sin? Why is it that they would choose to destroy their bodies, to destroy their families, to destroy their society, to destroy even their human species, despite their desire for happiness? It is because of a faulty and defective and distorted vision. ضعف البصيرة, a distorted basira, distorted vision and perception. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and it's reported that Umar would made this dua also, he would say, Allahumma arina al-haqqa haqqa warzuqna attiba'a. Oh Allah, allow us to see the truth as truth and enable us to follow it. Wa arina al-batila batila warzuqna ijtinaba, and allow us to see falsehood as falsehood and allow us to refrain from it. Because my dear respected brothers and sisters, the one who considers sinning and disobeying Allah is a means to happiness and prosperity, it is not because they are inherently bad, they're not naturally bad, but because of a distorted perception of the truth. And the one who remains steadfast and upright upon his deen is the one who sees the reality of affairs. He is the one whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has allowed to see the reality of charity. Charity will not decrease your wealth, it will increase your wealth. He has allowed him to see the reality of zina, of fornication, that sexual deviance and corruption is not free expression of pure love. No, it's depravity. The believer whom Allah has allowed to see and granted him basira sees things as they are, sees the reality of affairs. The incorrect perception, my dear respected brothers, that abstaining from the haram is and the prohibitions is restrictive, is the vision of the one whom Allah has blinded, my dear respected brothers and sisters. Those who think that charity will cause poverty, that praying will waste their time, that fasting will weaken them, that is all due to a weak and flawed perception. Those people do not possess basira. Continuing on from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's beautiful and divine name, Al-Basir, we know that His names, like His glorious book, the Quran, never cease to amaze, and never cease to give generously. The believer continues to rise with Allah's names and elevate in station. Like he does from the level of Iman to Ihsan, he ascends to a level higher than Ihsan also, and that is the level of Yaqeen, the level of certainty and surety. Ali radiallahu anhu, he said, if the veil were removed, meaning the veil between him and Allah were removed, my faith in Allah would not increase. His faith is so sound and firm that he requires no evidence, meaning that he has reached a level of certainty beyond any shadow of a doubt in the existence, power, knowledge, wisdom and justice of Allah, that he does not require evidence in the form of gazing upon the divine essence to prove to him the existence of Allah. Yaqeen, my dear respected brothers and sisters, is the objective of every Muslim. The Muslim does not seek the lowest level. The Muslim seeks the highest level. So my dear respected brothers and sisters, we are commanded to fear Allah and to obey Him, and know that He is ever watchful over us. We must train ourselves to imagine His majesty before us while we are in worship, and to train our hearts to be present in worship as well as our bodies, so that we may be more conscious of Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us yaqeen in Him, and grant us certainty in His power to save us from every grief, from every poverty, from every sickness, from every fear, and from every hardship. For He is able to remove all obstacles from our path, and He is the one alone who grants us salvation. هذا وصلوا وسلموا على خير الأنام فإن الله أمركم بأمر بدأ به بنفسه وثنى بملائكة قدسه ثم بكم أيها المؤمنون فقال جل من قائل إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين وأعلي بفضلك كلمتي الحق والدين اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزد لكم وأقم الصلاة
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله